So far in this course, we've built out a hero section, navigation, an entire project section driven by a visual CMS, a contact form, and a footer. And we're going to take all of this and ensure it's both responsive and fluid on all different devices. We'll do this on desktop, tablet, mobile landscape, mobile portrait, and we'll add a larger breakpoint for devices like the iMac or the Pro Display XDR and on other larger displays. Let's start with desktop. Up here, this is our base breakpoint. This is the default breakpoint from which we design everything else. We can grab the edge right here and test fluidity, see how everything's responding. And something to note right away, we created that custom container. And that custom container, which has the container class, has a maximum width of 1200, and that works pretty well. But things get really close to the edge here. So what we might want to do is add some padding. Let's say 20 pixels on both sides, so that it's not going right up to the edge. In fact, if we want it squared off, we might want to make it 30 pixels on each side. Now, if we test responsiveness, if we test fluidity, it looks like it works on all different widths. We can see right here, this is the iPad Pro, the 12.9 inch. We can widen here, this is the Retina MacBook, the 12 inch. Over here is MacBook Air 11 inch. This is MacBook Pro, the earlier 15s. And this is the MacBook Pro 13 and the MacBook Air, the 13 inch models. It looks good on all these widths. Let's scroll down, let's see how these are performing. They look pretty good. Let's check our contact form and our footer. All of it seems to be working great on all of these widths. Let's move on to tablet. And just by glancing at it, tablet actually looks okay. We might want to adjust the section, that 60 pixels on the top and bottom with that more limited real estate. Might want to drop that to maybe 30 pixels on the top and bottom. Let's do that, see how this responds. Looks pretty good here. We can see that by default, our navbar has switched to drop-down navigation. So let's go into preview mode and let's click that little hamburger menu. And we might not love this color. So let's click out of preview mode. Let's double click. We're gonna edit our symbol. Let's click the menu button. We can go over to our element settings and we can open that menu. And with our menu button selected, let's make it a different color. Let's say black looks pretty good. And let's select our nav links. Again, we have two different classes here. We have the nav link and then we have the nav link button class. So we might want to make them more even. So let's say the padding on the top and bottom, let's make it 10 pixels on the top and bottom, and the nav link, same thing, 10 pixels on the top and bottom. And there's some space here. So if we click that nav link, we still have that margin on the top. Let's remove that. And let's change the nav link color here. Also, let's just do black. That looks pretty good. The second one here, let's change that to black. Remember, we're affecting the combo class, that's navlink and button. It's grayed out right now, but that's because it's carrying over that opacity we did when we were styling on the base breakpoint when we first made it. Let's bring that all the way up so it's a solid black color. And we're still getting that rounding, so let's turn off that rounding. Now, it should work okay. We should be able to go in here, trigger that, open menu, close menu, open menu, close menu. That seems to be responding just fine. So, tablet, how are we doing with responsiveness and fluidity? We're looking pretty good on each of these. Even as it gets more narrow, it's looking pretty good. This form looks great. This footer looks great. That's tablet. Let's move on to mobile landscape. Things are getting a little tighter on mobile landscape. Let's maybe decrease this heading. So, decrease this size. Let's make it 24. Maybe a little higher, 30. We can decrease our line height. Let's use unitless, and let's choose something like 1.1. That looks pretty good there. The container seems to have some space underneath. Is it that heading? Yeah, that's 60 pixels. Let's make that 30. And now, if we go back here, we can see even, well, we do want to change that. The heading here still had the 60. Let's change that to 30. But even as we make changes to these smaller breakpoints, notice how they're not affecting. We made the heading size 30, but that didn't affect the tablet. That's because changes start on the base breakpoint and they cascade down to smaller devices and they cascade up to larger devices or larger displays, which we'll get to in a bit. So a change we make on tablet will affect mobile landscape, but a change we make on mobile landscape won't affect tablet or desktop. So we're on mobile landscape. This is looking pretty good. There's a lot of space here. Maybe the section 30 is a little tight. Let's maybe make that 15. Decrease the H2 size since we decreased the other one. That looks a little better, 22. Maybe on this we can decrease that a little more. That looks good. We can actually select our power graph and maybe we want that a little tighter as well. Maybe 13 pixels, do that here as well. Here's the question. What's going on here? Why are each of these images clipped off? Well, if we go back to desktop, you'll notice we never actually set a height here. The height is being determined by the image inside. So if we make these widths 200 pixels, notice how it's actually clipping everything off. In order to do this properly, we might want to make a different change. We might want to select this image element and make its width 100% and its height 100%. And right now it's a little squished, but it's respecting the content on the page. Here's what that means. Let's add some extra content. Notice how, as we add more paragraphs, it's stretching. The image is stretching to take up the space that's created by all this extra text. And as we undo that, it squishes down. One thing we can do with this image selected is we can set its cover, its fit to cover. And now it's going to clip off and respect those dimensions. So how do we set a different dimension? How do we set these to be a little bit taller? We could just go in and select the project details div block here, and we can set its height to something like, let's do minimum height so it doesn't clip anything off. Let's set it to 500 pixels. That's looking pretty good. And here's what that did in mobile. Notice how now that side-by-side is still clipped off, but it's no longer shrinking that image. That image is always taking up the space inside the grid, and that's being determined by this div block. Let's go back to tablet. Maybe we want to make this 300. That looks pretty good. Let's go to mobile landscape. And in mobile landscape, we might not like the side-by-side design. It looks pretty good here. Maybe we want to make it half and half. So let's create one. Let's make this one FR. Let's see what a side-by-side looks like. That looks pretty good. Let's see. So we resize. This looks pretty good on mobile landscape. Let's try mobile portrait. Okay, it's a little too tight here. Let's go in and edit our grid, and let's remove that second column. But where did our image go? We set its width and its height to 100%. And because we removed that second column, we're left with a 1x1 grid. But we have this invisible row here that contains our image. Right now, it has 0 pixels of height. So the image is taking up 100% of those 0 pixels. So now, let's change a minimum height. Let's say 200 pixels. Now we can see the images again. Let's go in. Let's maybe remove that spacing here. This is looking pretty good. So we have each card, maybe we can decrease this minimum height, just remove that minimum height. Let's just do auto. That's looking pretty good. Maybe we can push off the button text here. Let's push off on the top, create 15 pixels of space. This is looking pretty good. Each project has its image and its description. Let's check our contact form and our footer. Too tight here as well. Let's go into contact form. That grid we created before, let's remove that column. So now we have everything that should stack nicely. Let's escape. Contact form looks okay. What about this Macon Garcia portfolio? Actually, before we move on to that, let's double click. Let's make the submit button. Let's make it take up the full width. That looks better. And we'll hit escape. And for this portfolio footer, let's resize. It doesn't look too good as things get narrow. So let's go in here and let's take this collection list, which is also a grid, and let's remove 3 of the columns. It just automatically creates rows, 1 row each for each of these. And as we test responsiveness and fluidity now, it responds just fine. Another thing about the container, 30 pixels, it looks pretty good, but as this gets narrow, that's a lot of space. Notice how this little menu bar icon is also moving. So let's change each of those. For the container, let's decrease this padding. Let's do maybe 10 pixels, that looks okay. So as we resize, that looks good. Maybe the spacing in between each of these looks good at 30. We could go in and go to our collection item and change that from 30 to maybe 10 as well. That looks good. And let's see what's going on with the button up on the top, the menu button. As this gets narrow, the logo is pushing that menu button to the right. So we could do a few things. The easiest might be to take Megan Garcia portfolio, setting a different width on mobile portrait here. Let's do 150 pixels, a little bit smaller. Then we can select our brand and add a little more space. Let's do 18 on the top and bottom, maybe 19 on the top and bottom. That looks pretty good. And if we drag and resize now, let's hit escape to go out of that symbol. Even on the narrowest device, everything works okay. Now, here's one of our favorite parts. If we go into preview mode, regardless of what breakpoint we're in, we can click and drag to reflow through all of the breakpoints. Notice how we're in desktop, now we're in tablet, mobile landscape, mobile portrait. It goes through all of them to test responsiveness and fluidity of all our elements. Fully responsive design on all of these. Now, what if we want to create a larger breakpoint? Well, we can do that too. Let's go out of preview mode. Let's go up here and we can add larger breakpoints, 1280, 1440, or 1920. Let's add 1920 for much larger displays. Now, something interesting just happened. We're on a Pro Display XDR, but the window size is roughly 1920 by 960. It's at 2x, it's at Retina when we're capturing this, so we can capture in 4K. But notice how we are looking at a width of 1920. Then we have this other number right here, the 76.7%. Webflow has scaled all the elements on the page so we can simulate what it will look like on a larger breakpoint. In fact, if we grab the edge right here, we can click and drag even more to see what it looks like on a larger screen, maybe 3,000 pixels wide. Let's decrease that. We can go all the way back down to 1920. To show 1920 pixels in a canvas this size on our browser, even if we're on a smaller display, it's had to scale down the elements, and that's okay. It looks good. We could maybe increase the container width to, let's say, 1600 pixels. Just widen that out. That looks pretty good. Maybe we want a larger heading on our larger display. Let's switch it to maybe 56, and let's increase that height. Let's use unitless, 1.2. We'll use a little hyphen here, enter. 1.1 might be better. And let's get rid of that maximum width, or let's make that a lot wider. So we're gonna increase that to 780. That looks good. Selected projects, maybe our H2s can get bigger. Again, let's do 1.1 hyphen, and then let's increase that. That looks a lot better. Maybe with our paragraph selected, some more space at the bottom. We can change these things a little bit later. Let's do 30. That looks pretty good for now. But that's our larger breakpoint. Again, we can go to preview mode and we can see all of this in action. Let's grab the edge. We can click and drag and we can see what it looks like on 1920, desktop, tablet, and mobile devices. Now, we always want to switch back to our base breakpoint. We want to do all of our basic designing, all of our standard designing in the base breakpoint. And then when we're testing responsiveness and fluidity and we're building different designs, so we're adjusting our designs for each breakpoint, then we can switch over to tablet, mobile landscape, we can go back up to our 1920. We always want to go back to our base breakpoint when we add new elements and style. That's our starting point. But with that, we've completed our first pass on the homepage. Is it 100%? It's pretty close. We're definitely going to revisit it, but there are two other pages we want to build out. We'll build out a project details page, details about each project in Megan's portfolio, and we'll add a separate contact page we can link to throughout the project.
You know what I'm thinking?
Yes.
Okay, what am I thinking about?
On three.
Okay. One, two, three,
food.
Lunch. Did I have the food face?
What is food face?
How did you know I was hungry?
Because.
But seriously, lunch.
After lunch, the project details page.
But first, share your finished homepage, or maybe your draft, using hashtag 21dayportfolio. Twister, Stangram, Susie Frost. Why? Well, I want to see them, but we also want to share your work, because we're proud of you. And I really mean that. We're humbled and honored. Hey, can you wait for me?